Iron was one of the early products made here at Jamestown. John Smith writes about making little chisels in 1607, just a couple of 3 months after they were here. They were using local iron ore because one of the things they wanted to do was find a commodity they could sell or use commercially. And there's a lot of ore around here, a lot of limonite that's found in layers. I believe the Jamestown formation goes all the way up to Maryland. It's a huge formation. Some of it makes good iron and some of it does not. The process is to collect that ore off the banks of the James River or other places and roast it in an open fire. The roasting removes some of the oxygen. More importantly, it makes it friable so you can break it up into stuff about the size of rock salt. Once you have that done, it goes into a bloomery furnace. A bloomery furnace is a little bit like a chimney, as you can see in the film. It's loaded from the top with layers of charcoal and iron ore, and it filters down to the bottom to the air blast, the area of the air blast in front of the tuer, which is just about the melting point of iron. What happens in that journey down is the iron ore combines with the carbon monoxide coming off of the charcoal. The carbon monoxide takes the oxygen away from the iron ore and leaves behind iron droplets and molten sand. That comes down to the bottom and you get a lot of slaggy material, which is sand and waste material in the iron, mixed with iron ore called a bloom. Once you have the bloom out, you might have anywhere from 15 to 40 pounds of it. It's cut into sections and forged into bars. Those bars cause the slag that remains in it, as much as 10%, to elongate into fibers and creates the classic wrought iron that people had been using for about 3,000 years by the time we arrived at Jamestown. It's an important material because we were deep into the Iron Age by then. No commercial production ever occurred at Jamestown. They built a furnace up at a place called Falling Creek around 1620, and it was apparently just getting into production when the Indian Uprising started in 1622, and that's where it started. Virginia didn't get back into iron making for nearly another 100 years. But right here at this site is a place that we've spent time making iron using the most ancient methods known to man that were probably still used up until the 20th century, early 20th century in places.